All right, you made the right decision and want to ride around Bali on a scooter. Here's everything you need to know. First off, it's not gonna cost you much. Prices go from 600K to 850. If you're paying more, you're either going for premium or you got ripped off. What to look for in a scooter? Go for the seasoned veterans. They've been places. An extra scratch here or an extra scratch there, no one will notice. Then check your BLSF, brakes, lights, speed, and fuel gauge. If one of those isn't working, go to your scooter guy and ask for a different scooter. If your dodgy bike didn't come with a dodgy helmet, here's how much you'll pay for one. The cheaper ones go from 2 to 300K, and you can find them in scooter gear shops all over Bali. If you want a more premium one, you'll probably end up paying 10 times more than that. Before you buy the helmet, make sure it comes with a visor. Why? Because if you don't have one, bugs will constantly fly in your eyes, mouth, and face. When you're going about your daily cruising, get yourself a clear visor rather than a shaded one, because you'll be able to use it at night as well. So, you've got yourself a helmet. What do you do with it when you get someplace? Well, there are a couple of options. If it feels safe enough, hang it over your side mirrors. If you're not comfortable with that, bring it with you. And if you don't want to bring it with you, hang it on these small hooks in your seat compartment. All right, you're feeling confident, drove around a little, and found the many shortcuts scooters get to benefit from, but now you find yourself out of fuel and you don't know which vodka bottle to choose from. Well, in my experience, the yellow rocket fuel got me just as far as the blue one, but at a cheaper price. If you ask Google, someone will probably tell you the blue one is better though. Before you fuel up, make sure you specify an amount. For example, 2 bottles, or if it's a pump, specify for how much you want to fuel. Otherwise, they might charge you more. Lastly, before my last tip, if you find yourself lost because you have a terrible navigator, don't, and I repeat, don't buy one of the cheaply available phone holders, because they will break down and ruin your phone when it smacks the ground relentlessly during one of your bumpy escapades. Now, as a bonus, I'll give you a great place to let loose and drive on the beach. Pasut Beach, famous for its black sands and over Instagram palm trees, is one of the only places in Bali where you're allowed to drive vehicles on the beach. It's an hour or two away from Ubud, Canggu, or Denpasar, but with all the tips I've given you, I'm sure you'll manage. Now, scoot on out of here and see you next time.